Hello, everyone. Katinze, I did not write a speech. Naye, I've just come to make some noise. Kati, Joshua is my brother. I'm the youngest in the family. And in my household, we've all we grew up taking care of each other. And I just want to share a brief thing of when my view of Joshua shift and I saw him become a man. It was when we were still in the States. I think I was in college still, and me and Josh were at the house alone. Mom and Dad were over here in Uganda. And Joshua took care of me. Inze, Kati, I had refused to learn how to cook. Eh? It was a young adolescent phase. I now know it's okay. I'll marry well. But I had refused to learn how to cook, so I didn't know how to cook. So Josh used to have to buy for us food every day. And he did it without making you feel like he was doing something for you. You know how someone will take care of you and they'll make you feel like they're really taking care of you? Josh, he took care of me and he gave me the liberty of still living in, I'm in my parents' home, you know? And that's something that's so special, especially in a man who's called to provide for his family. So, Joanne, you really got the best, and I'm mad at you. You took my brother. Guys, I came home one day, and I went to Joshua's room to disturb him. Small. I usually don't disturb him. He's usually the one that disturbs me. I went to his room, and his room was empty. Everything was gone. The sukkahs, his book clothes, the hangers. Guys, the hangers. He took the hangers. I was offended. I was like, okay, this is what we're doing, eh? You just move and you don't tell anyone. Kali, as if we're not connected. I am still connected. Mkwano, nakupangisa omwami. Hey, chitegere. Understand. Kati, me and Joanne, we've been friends, right? So we met through Frisera, and then I brought her home with me because we just had we had a sisterly connection. I don't understand. One night, and we just became best friends. Anyway, Josh soon came in to ruin my wonderful new sister experience. He came in to take he came in to take my friend away. I remember we went to go visit my cousin. We went to a boarding school to visit my cousin, and it was his visitation day, and we had to wear our long dresses because it was a male's boarding school. Kati, we came together. Me and Joanne were sitting close. Josh was in the front. Everyone was minding their business. Then Josh started, cracking with jokes at Joanne, and then Joanne starts doing what? She starts giggling. I did not say laugh, I said giggle. She was giggling like a little girl, and I was looking at her and I was like, eh, 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 eh. it's true. I was like, what's happening here? And then on the ride back, Joshua and Joanne were sitting next to each other. I said, what is this? God help me. Eh, 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 eh. And then, Josh, don't interrupt, okay? Okay, thank you. So we continued, and I just saw their friendship develop, and they became closer. And through them being together, Josh really developed into the man that he is today, the prayerful man that he is, the man that is about purpose, that is about kingdom, not just thinking about living life, but just thinking about making an impact that is going to change a generation to know who God is, to know who they are in Him, and to know who they're called to be. So guys, as you continue, this is not just for fun. This is a holy union. pray for them. Every time you think about them, pray for Josh and Joanne. There's a heavy mantle of anointing that has been placed on this household. There's a deep responsibility that God has over their lives and over their union. So let's just protect them in prayer and cover them. Anyway, I've been told to keep my speech short. I have a lot to say, but I will cut it short. Muwonye. Kale.